Okay, good morning to all. Today I discuss about system calls. So far we covered types of operating systems, OS concepts, OS services. Now let us discuss about system call. System calls are the set of extended instructions acts as an interface between user and the operating system. Normally, your operating system will be executed in two modes. One as user mode, second one as kernel mode. Kernel mode. User mode means all the user entered instructions or commands are forwarded to the kernel. Means user entered programs or some commands, $.date, it displays the current date. Means all the user entered commands are to be executed in the user mode. Kernel mode means the set of programs transferred by the user are entered to the kernel. Now kernel will take care of all the resource allocation, allocation of your keyboard, monitor, printer, everything will be handled by the kernel. That kernel mode you are also called as a supervisory mode or privileged mode. Means kernel is the heart of the operating system. The kernel will take care of every execution of the user's programs. Depending upon the available requirements of the hardware, it will execute the programs. System call provides the services of the operating system to the user programs through some interface. That interface you are called it as API, application program interface. For example, consider any language, you have Java. Java has Java API, that is the JVM, Java virtual machine. For example, you consider Windows operating system, then they have an API as Win32 API, Win32-bit application program interface. This interface provides between process and operating system to allow all the user level process to request the services of the operating system. Because the OS will provide several operating system services, you know, program creation, program execution, resource allocation, protection, security, error correction and debugging, everything will be done by the operating system. Then it provides interface between your user and the OS. System calls are only the entry points to the kernel system. All program needing resources, you must use the system calls. That kernel will allocate all the resources to that particular user. These system calls are written in a high level language like C or C++. Only these two languages only used. Now, should I? Therefore, this diagram. API system call versus OS relationship means here user mode, kernel mode. Always the OS will be operated in two modes or dual mode, you are called it as. One as user mode, second one as kernel mode. Now, user mode, consider user mode. There is a user application. That application will be forwarded to the system call interface. Means it will be forwarded to the kernel with the help of these system calls. Open is a system call. System call in considering your C language, you have the predefined functions. That function you are called as system call with respect to the OS perspective. Open is a system call. Means to execute that open system call, the OS will be switch to the kernel mode. This switching is called as the context switching. Context switching means the OS will move from one mode to the another mode, user mode to the kernel mode, and vice versa, kernel mode to the user mode. Now this open implementation of open system call, some it returns the file may be opened or not to the end user. This is the relationship between OS and the system call. system called parameter passing. Normally, if you want to pass the parameters through that system calls, you have various methods are there. Simplest method, pass the parameters by means of a registers, you know, AHEAL, BHBL, CHCL, some general purpose registers are there. With the help of those general purpose registers, you have to pass the parameters. But in some cases, there may be more parameters than the available registers. There existence of more parameters than the available registers. That is a problem in simplest method. Second method has parameters stored in a block or table in memory and address of a block passed as a parameter in a register. Means consider your Linux or Solaris operating system. Those two operating systems will be passed the parameters to the system call with respect to a block or table. Means entire data must be saved in a table and that placed in the memory, and it will pass the address of that particular block. It will be transferred to that particular registers. Then parameters passed are pushed onto the stack. If you want to use LIFO, list in first out stack, then if you want to pop the values or push the values, parameters may be pushed after that return values will be popped from the stack of the operating system. And last method is block and stack methods do not limit the number of length of parameters being passed. Means you have three methods. One is simplest method. Second one is parameter stored in a block or table or in memory. And address of that particular block will be passed as a parameter in a register. Third method is parameters placed or pushed onto the stack. These two last two methods, block and stack methods, do not limit the number of length of parameters being passed. There is no limit. You should pass any number of parameters with the help of block method or stack method. First one have the restriction. That restriction may be more parameters than the available registers. This is regarding your system call parameter passing. Next, I move to the parameter passing via table. This is the user program. This side, on the right hand side, you have the operating system. I want to pass the X parameters for call. If you want to call any function, you have to pass the parameters. In a similar way, you have to pass the parameters. Load address X, system call 13. System call will have identifier, some ID will be there. Based upon that ID, you have to pass the system call parameters to that register X. Use that parameters. Use the parameters from table X. This is the table. Use the parameters from table X, and OS will execute this type of parameters, and again value will be returned to the main program. That is the normal execution of any user program and the operating system. System call performed in a series of steps. Consider it is a memory layout. You have the user space and kernel space. That kernel space, it will allocate the OS addresses from 0 to FFF because it is a 32-bit or 64-bit computer. Consider here a dispatch and system call handler. Two modules are there here. Starting from first step, first one push n bytes. You have to pass some values to that particular system call push n bytes. Push and buffer, those bytes values will be stored in the registers. Push FD, third step, push the file descriptor. All the values are permanently stored in a file. If the file descriptor is a valid number, then it creates a file. If it is a minus one value, there is no file will be created. Then call the read method. It will be moved to the, put the code for the read in register, step five. The code will be placed into the main memory. Then your stack pointer will be incremented. SP is equal to SP plus 2 bytes. After fifth one, all the code must be dispatched from user mode to the kernel mode. 5 to 6, once observe this diagram, 5 to 6. The dispatch module will dispatch the user code or running currently running program code. That code must be placed into the kernel space and ready for execution. That is the sixth step. A dispatcher is a software module which will dispatches the program code or part of the code. It will be move the code from dispatches the code from user space to the kernel space. That switching of programs from user to the kernel mode called as a context switching. The switching are called as context switching. The dispatcher is a software module which will move the program from user mode to the kernel mode. After the results will be again move from kernel mode to the user mode. After seventh step, the system call handler, the function will be executed. Then it move to the return to the caller. Values will be moved to the return statement. Return statement always pass the values to the user. Again trap to the kernel. Increment again stack pointer -2 if you want to return. Then final step as move the values to the user. These are the executed by library procedure read operations. User program calling read. Here read is a system call. Return is a predefined function in C language. These are the various series of steps to execute all the user programs with the help of system call. With this diagram, you should understand as a system program is an instruction given by the user to the kernel of the operating system to execute your program. That instruction you are called as a system. Any doubts in this diagram? Any doubts in this diagram? Let us discuss about system call types, process control, file manipulation, device manipulation, protection and communication, and information security. System calls are there. Let us discuss about process control system calls. System calls are the instructions given by the user to the OS. Means user entered instructions are called as system calls. These are by means of C language instructions like sleep, wait. Likewise, you have the various types of system calls. Coming to the process control system calls, create the process, terminate the process, end the process, abort the process, you have to load the process, execute the process, get the process attribute, set process attributes, wait for time, wait for an event, signal for an event, allocate and free memory, dump memory if errors, debugger for determining bugs, single step execution, locks for managing access to shared data between processes. All these operations are going to be performed by these process control system calls. Already explained, to create a process, you have to use fork system call. Are you audible?